Thank you. wakati Mungu awabariki na aongezee awazidishie hiyo karama.
Hallelujah.
Asante sana.
Thank you so much.
Basi tunafikia kwa muda mzuri.
We are in good time again.
Tutaenda kusikiliza matangazo.
We are going to hear our announcement.
Kisha tunaendelea.
And then we go forward.
Hallelujah. Karibu administrator.
Welcome our administrator for the announcement. Makofi na vigelegele kabisa.
Yo, tunatoa matangazo yetu kama kawaida.
We are giving our announcement as usually.
Tunasema kwamba tunakuwa hapa kila Jumapili kama leo, tunaanza ibada yetu
saa 7 here on Sunday as usually, which we start our service from 11 until 1 o'clock.
Na sote tunakaribishwa kwa mkutano wa saa 5 hadi saa 7.
And each and everybody, we are welcome to the service from 11 until 1.
Wednesday tunakuwa na saa 1 hapa saa 12 hadi saa 1.
Wednesday we are here from 6 until 7.
Kwa ajili ya maombi.
It's for prayer.
Na sote tunakaribishwa.
And we are welcome.
Saturday inakuwa ni maombi ni Bible study.
Saturday is a Bible study.
Na tunaanza saa 5 na kwenda hadi saa 7.
Where we start 11 until 1 p.m.
Sote tunakaribishwa kwa Bible study.
And we are all welcome for that Bible study.
Ili tujifunze neno la Mungu.
So that you can study the word of God.
Tunakumbusha tayari kuendelea kukumbusha kwamba tunakutana.
We just remind you, we have a seminar.
Na sisi tutafanya huo mkutano uweze kuonekana vizuri zaidi kwa sisi tunaweza kuattend kwa hiyo siku tatu.
If all of us we can attend for those 3 days.
Na sisi kwa agenda zetu sisi tusisahau.
We have to put on our agenda so that we cannot forget.
Tarehe 31 wa mwezi wa 5.
The 31st of this month of May.
Saa 11 hadi saa 1 tunakuwa hapa.
From 5 until 7 we'll be here.
Tarehe 2 ya mwezi wa 6 tunakuwa tena hapa itakuwa Saturday.
And the Saturday we will be here again. At the first, we're going to be here of June.
Hiyo hiyo masaa 11 hadi saa 1 ya jioni.
Same time from 5 until 7 in the night.
Na mkutano wetu unafunga Jumapili ambayo itakuwa saa 5 hadi saa 7 tano za asubuhi kama kawaida.
And the Sunday is going to be the closure. We're going to start same time 11 until 1.
Sote tunakaribisha kwa hizo siku tatu ili Mungu atubariki pamoja.
And we all welcome for those 3 days so that we can be blessed together.
Tunasema hivyo hivyo kwamba tunaendelea kuwa na vikapu mbili vya kuchanga sadaka zetu mahali hapa.
We continue to say we have a 2 baskets where we offer here.
Kikapu ya kawaida, moja ya 10, ujenzi na sadaka tunachanga katika kikapu kikubwa.
The first basket is for offering your tithe, your construction, we put it in that big basket.
Na vile vile kama kuna mkate wa watumishi ambao watakuja wanachia watatunga kidogo.
And if you have the bread that for the visitor who's coming, you can put in the small basket.
So ni utaratibu tunasema tutakuwa nao mpaka hadi wageni wetu wakuja kutoka Amerika.
That's how we're gonna do until the visitors are coming from America.
Nafikiri hayo ndio matangazo tulionayo hapa kanisani.
I think all that's the announcement that we have here in the church.
Basi na Mungu wetu awabariki.
God bless you all.
Narudisha microphone kwa kiongozi wetu.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Usinipite Bwana, usinipite. Unapogusa wengine, usinipite. Tuimbe tafadhali na tushimame. Omba dakika mbili kabla tuende toa sadaka. Hallelujah. Kila mtu ashimame, usiwe wa kukaa.
Stand up, stand up, please. Kama utajisikia
kukaa, kama utajisikia kukaa,
if you feel to see,
mtu mgonjwa unaweza fika hapa mbele akakuombea.
If you are sick,
hallelujah,
you can just come forward here.
Kama unajisikia uko mgonjwa,
if you feel you are sick,
tafadhali uje hapa mbele akuombea.
It's better you come forward.
Usinipite unapogusa wengine, na mimi kusi. Hallelujah. karibu pamoja. Sadaka na chakumi usisahau.
Offering and tithe, don't
forget. Yes! Katika jina lako.
Mwambie Mungu.
Let us
pray.
Thank you.
tunamkaribisha mzee wetu mtombo kwa neno la Mungu. Jiandae hapa mbele kwa ajili ya neno la Mungu.
The word of God.
Tuamini na tuombe. Baba tunashukuru, tunasema asante kwa kuendelea kwa pamoja nasi tangu tulipoanza na tunaendelea tukiwa pamoja na wewe Mungu wetu. Tunaenda kukabidhi mtumishi wako ambaye tulisha neno lako katika mikono yako Bwana. Anaposimama Bwana tusimuone tena kama ni yeye anasimama, lakini tuone ni wewe unasimama ndani yake ili azungumze na kanisa. Baba umuongoze kwa njia ya maalumu anaposimama. Baba vile vile uongoze umati huu kanisa lote nzima, tuwe tayari Bwana kufungua masikio yetu ya kiroho ili tulishwe na neno lako. Tunaamini ya kwamba Bwana utakuwa na yule atakaye mtafsiri ili Bwana tuweze kuwa na ibada njema kupitia neno lako. Asante Mwokozi kwa sababu kuna upako kanisani mwako, katika jina la Yesu Kristo Mwokozi wetu, amen.
Haleluya. Haleluya. Tunaenda kusikiliza neno la Mungu.
We're going to hear the word of God.
Lakini nitasema nisipitiwa kidogo.
I just forgot a little bit.
Tutasema karibu kwa kanisa lote mzima.
Oh, we say welcome to the church. Kanisa la church, welcome. Welcome among us.
Wamama mko.
Tupo. So we are going to speak about
Pentecost.
The Pentecost, God spoke to his children.
the disciples, how they were looking, they were walking.
They were not walking like
people are walking in a multiple way, but they were together. They didn't walk each on his own direction. They were sitting together. They were discussing together. They ate together. And they have one idea.
As
today, we regard like we are the same as the disciples. Are we working as the old disciples? We are looking for the Holy Spirit. How are we going to receive Holy Spirit? You are receiving the Holy Spirit when you search for God. Because He is our own example. When He went, Jesus Christ, and then He said, I won't leave you behind by yourself. I'm going to send you a helper that is the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit
is going to
teach you more than what I taught you. Because it's the Holy Spirit who is going to guide you. So you're my child, walk this way. Do not go the other side. If you do this, you will die early. But if you go in this way, you maybe have more, a lot of curses. Then why he's showing
you?
Because when you have a Holy Spirit in you, you will understand and know many things. You will understand, you have knowledge to understand good and bad.
Amen.
Amen.
And before I continue forward, I'm
going to
sing even for 2 minutes.
We are going to read the book of Acts.
Actes des Apôtres, chapitre 2.
Second Act.
Chapitre 2, verset 1 à 21. Leto tashikana kuna kani Mungu alizungumza na watoto wake na naona kani alipata Roho Mtakatifu kwa sababu Mungu wetu tunaomba na yeye uwabinyo yote. Utashike mwendo wenyewe huko.
Amen.
Wakati na apostle bana bapaba kabila moja bana.
So the disciple of Jesus wasn't in the, for the same tribes.
Karibu wasomaji wetu.
Acts 21 says, when the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues, as the Spirit enabled them. Now they were staying in Jerusalem, God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard the sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment because of one of them hearing language being spoken. Utterly amazed, they asked, "Aren't these all speaking Galilean? Then who is it that each of us hear them in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya near Cyrene, visitors from Rome, Cretans and Arabs, we hear them declare the wonders of God in our own tongue. Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, what does this mean? Some, however, made fun of them and said they had had too much wine. Then Peter stood up with the 11 and raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Fellow Jews and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people are not drunk as you suppose. It is only 9 in the morning. No. This is what is spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all the people. Your sons, your daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in heaven above and signs on the earth below. Blood and water, blood and fire, and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. 21. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
So we had our reader just have a wonderful reading. And someone who have ears had already. Because in front of God, there is no tribe. There is no one mouth. When you see someone speak, his mouth. The what is important is to listen. And if you have Holy Spirit in you,
it's
going to guide you.
Utajua kila anasema.
So you understand what the day has been spoken. Because we just had what has been spoken.
Sana.
They said there was a multiple tribe. But they came together. And each tribe was speaking in their own language. But they can hear each other. They can hear each other in their own language.
Amen.
Amen.
The
reason why we are saying
it,
when you are looking for God
moja,
with your heart,
yako,
the way you search for your God,
na Mungu atakutafuta.
And God is going to look for you too.
Amen.
Amen.
Hii ni mwendo ya watumwa wa Bwana.
This is the how disciples of Jesus have to walk.
Namna walikuwa anatembea na Yesu.
The way they were walking with Jesus.
Ndio pale na sisi tunasema kama.
The same way we are saying.
Tuko na tafuta Yesu.
We are looking for God.
Tutembee mfano mmoja.
We have to follow this example. So we can be blessed.
Tukitembea kila mtu pande yake.
If we are divided.
Ila kwa amuna mmoja wetu.
We won't be in unity. It's going to be a division.
Amen.
Amen.
Isomaye wetu Kiswahili. Amen, amen, watoto wa Bwana. Siku ya Pentecost.
The day of Pentecost.
Waaminifu wote wa Bwana.
All the believers. They were gathering together.
Vile tunakutanisha na shida.
The way we are here.
Tunaomba kumtafuta Mungu.
We are here to look for God.
Tunaomba kumtafuta juu ya nini?
Why we are looking for God?
Kila mtu na maisha yake achana.
Because we have multiple different problems.
Atesha kwa nyumba yake.
We have more different problems.
Mambo ya kazi.
Maybe if, about your work.
Kwa sababu Yesu alisema.
Because Jesus said.
Yule atanitafuta mimi.
The one who is going to look for me.
Kila kitu atatomba mjini yangu.
Everything he's going to pray and by name. I will give to him.
Sikia Bwana anasema ile wakati ya Pentecost.
So they said the day for the Pentecost.
Walikuwa pamoja.
They were together.
Hapakuwa kila mtu kuumba.
They didn't divide themselves.
Naangalia leo.
But read, look at today.
Kumba mabishi bado yanabakia wazi.
We have empty chairs.
Wewe kwa nyumba yako isa.
They stayed at home.
Wengine mara ndefu ya Mungu.
Other people they have a multiple round of appointments.
Wengine ndefu ya Yesu Kristo.
Then coming to the good appointment. So we can gather together looking for God.
There
is other people that are at wedding. And they invited to our friends. And then they forget to come to worship God. And then they'll start crying. I have multiple problems in my house. But you are looking for your own problem. The time to look for God. You are looking for God like a worldly happiness. Here, they are saying they were together on the day of Pentecost. It's the same as today. We are here to the church. If God
were
to divide the Holy Spirit here, it's
up to
upon here, we are here, we will receive it.
If
someone who is not here went to the appointment, he won't receive it. He's
going to
have their happiness over there. And then you miss the Holy Spirit. Amen. We have to be together so we can see the hand of God.
Amen. Amen, amen, watoto wa Bwana. Wakati ile walikuwa mnyumba mule basi kulichangisha pote pamoja.
At the time they were gathering in our house together.
Nashikia pepo moja nguvu sana.
Just had a huge wind going through.
Basi kama kelele mingi sana.
A big noise.
Mungurume sana tumeshika avio kama nafika hapo na nashikia.
The noise that big like a trumpet.
Na ile pepo ikajaza nyumba mzima mule barukuya.
The wind filled up the house where they were.
Bana shituka.
And there was all surprise. There was surprise.
Ni mambo gani hiyo?
What is going on?
Mambo gani fanyika huko?
What is going on?
Endelea. Amen, amen, watoto wa Bwana. Wakati na bari nichangamisha mnyumba mule.
So the time they were gathering together in a house.
Na wakati pepo iliala mnyumba mule kabisa.
And the wind filled the house.
Bengere mukushanga sana.
So the time they were so surprised.
Ni mambo gani matutokee shule?
What is going on?
Baki wana sipo tukatoka Afrika.
And then they were like, maybe they are coming from Africa.
Wakati mnaona mvule nafunga nguvu sana.
When you see like there was a wind, a cloud.
Inaanza kufanya mishale na ya moto.
And then there is a lot of thunder going on.
Ndio vile waliona mnyumba mule.
So the same way they saw it.
Bana pepo ilibajaza mnyumba mule.
When they saw the wind filled the house.
Baki wana ile moto inaangaza mnyumba mule nguvu sana.
And then there was like a blaze of fire going
through. Na ile moto ilikuwa katikati ya kichwa kila mmoja.
So that fire those was at the on top of the
some
so everyone was having that fire on top of the head. So they were so surprised. The question to themselves, where are
you
coming from? And the fire, where are you coming from? It was the Holy Spirit filling them.
Amen.
Amen. So
we have to look for God.
You
will receive the same fire.
And the nation is very weak.
What?
Amen, amen, watoto
bwana.
Amen. Wakati na basho kujaza na pepo ile iliingia mnyumba yao.
So the time they received the fire on the wind.
Kila mmoja alipata ile moto kwa kichwa yake.
So everyone received the Holy Spirit on top of him.
Na kila mtu anaanza kusema sasa kitu kwa nyumba huko.
And then they start speaking on the different languages.
Wewe anasema Kiswahili.
The one speaks Swahili.
Wewe anasema Kikasai hapo.
Another one start speaking in Kasai.
Wewe anasema lugha ya pasta moja.
And then maybe another one start speaking but each language was connected to each one.
Don't
this one speak their own mother tongue. And then someone will
understand.
Why?
Because
they were together. And the spirit who came to
them,
he connected them together.
Amen.
Amen.
But
are you looking God in your
house?
Or maybe to your work?
Or
maybe to
the
firewood where they invite you?
Is there you
are going to receive your Holy Spirit? You won't receive it
then.
We have to come together.
The
way the disciples was
together.
And then they were filled with the Holy Spirit. And then each one
starts
speaking their language. In different languages. And then we had all those languages that the Bible describes here.
It
was multiple cultures,
multiple languages.
And each tribe was speaking their language. But because they were together with the Holy Spirit, they can hear each other.
Amen.
Amen.
The same way as we are here. We have to speak one language so we can understand each other.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the Bible says in Jerusalem, they were sitting at one place.
There
was a worshiping at one place. There was praying at one place. They were praying God. And here in Canada, we have to be at one place. In prayer every day. Every day in prayer. Children of God. In Jerusalem, even here in Canada, we are people coming from different nations. We are here together in Canada, so we can worship together, look for God, to look for Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is just
like God.
There wasn't in the same tribe. It was different tribes. It's like an entire world, different tribes. Now here, even someone speaking their language. And he was just saying, I cannot hear you. The Bible here said there was one language. In Jesus, we have multiple tribes. And in Jesus, we have multiple languages.
But we are one as one, because Holy Spirit make us to be one.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
This is an example here. He spoke only Kikasai. And Kiswahili. Those are the two languages can speak. The two languages can speak with God. He cannot speak it with God in French. Even in English, he can't. He's going to speak with his God in his language. And the reason why he preached in Swahili, because he cannot speak English, he cannot preach in English. He cannot forget his own mouth.
Amen.
Why? Because we can receive a visitor. He speaks only English. Maybe he speaks in Swahili. Maybe he doesn't speak all those languages. Maybe he speaks only his own language. So we need an interpreter. So someone who's going to have to interpret everything. So he can listen to even a small message. So when they ask him about the preaching in another church, he's going to speak what he heard. And he's going to answer by saying they preach about this because he heard it. Reason why they say in Jerusalem they were there, multiple tribes, multiple people were there. They were speaking different languages. And they were praying God every day. But your God, you pray God maybe once a week. And through the week you have multiple appointments. And then you start complaining, I'm being sick every day. I've been suffering every day. I'm praying to God for a very long. But I'm not seeing any changes. You question yourself, where did you left your God? Are you walking with Him? Are you discussing with God with other people? Are you coming in communion with others? You are just in your culture. Maybe at yourself, one place. When they see you, just on Sunday. Amen. We have to be together. So we can receive the Holy Spirit. So we can speak different languages. But we can understand each other. Because we have one Holy Spirit. Because it's a promise from our Jesus. He said, I won't leave you. I'm
going to
send you a helper. And then he's going to guide you. The day of Pentecost. It's the day they receive the Holy Spirit. And they spoke different languages. And they was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. I'm here maybe in Bukavu or Lubumbashi. But when you speak, I can hear it in my own language. And everything you are speaking, I can hear it.
Do you hear me?
Why? Because there was one spirit. One spirit translating to each other. So if you don't have Holy Spirit in this house, when you hear someone is singing in their own language, and you're like, I cannot even hear that. It's because you don't have Holy Spirit. Because when they are singing, they are worshiping and glorifying God. And God is listening to them.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
So
they start questioning themselves. All of people are speaking here. They are not coming from Galilee. They are coming from different villages. Why? Because things they were speaking, someone coming from Galilee can hear, can listen. They are understanding, so it was a big surprise. It's because they had one Holy Spirit guiding to speak in one language.
Amen.
Amen. So the same, they were surprising. How come we can understand each one language? And we are not even the same language, we are not same tribe.
Amen.
Amen. But for example, I'm here. I never been Kasai or Bukavu. And then when Pastor Mondo is speaking in Bukavu's language, and then he can understand.
Do you mean?
Why? The Holy Spirit is guiding. The Holy Spirit is translating to the
person.
Because we are in unity.
When
we are one and one Holy Spirit, we will understand each other in a language. Because one Holy Spirit is guiding us.
Amen.
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 You saw, you can hear all the languages there.
He
wasn't one tribe. Because in Jesus we are many. But in the Holy Spirit we are one. The reason why they're giving all the description for the tribes. Each tribe was speaking in their own mother tongue. But there was one in the Holy Spirit. The one who made them in a unity is the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. They continue showing us how they came from different cities as well. And they all went together. The same way we are here together. We are here to search the face of God. So we can receive the Holy Spirit today as a promise. And that's why we are here standing up here in front of Him. We have to be one. So we can receive the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 kusikia na kusema kwa lugha zetu wenyewe mambo makubwa ya
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Pala barikuwa na lalamika, mwana kumutanisa mwini saa nge mwini wana kwa mfano Papa James pale.
I can hear the church sometime, I can see Papa James there.
Mutamona saa barikuwa na shimama kwa na sema, yes, sima luga luga.
You can hear the way he say Jesus when he are bouncing.
Ni roho mtakatifu na mwongozi.
The Holy Spirit is guiding him.
Iko na bila aliona.
Is that maybe it's so something.
Kwa barikuwa na sema.
And that was the reason why he is saying here.
Fresh up,
these people are coming from different places. Why they are speaking in our own language? How did they know our language? Because they were speaking with the wonderful God. The Holy Spirit was translating everything to each one. And that since they were gathering, there was maybe jealousy. Why they know our language? They're preaching in our language. Because they don't belong in our tribe. They're questioning themselves. Why? Because God wanted to put them together. The way He's mixing us together here. So we can be in a unity. So we can be one and receive Holy Spirit. Because the way you are here today is because of Him. If He didn't make you wake up today, you couldn't walk up today. That the song
of
Abraham is singing. We have to glorify our God because He has done the wonderful things in our life.
Amen.
Amen. So you can see that even people was having some jealousy. Why you saying they come from different city, different area? Why they come here and start speaking our language? The reason why it's showing you how
to speak.
The way God could walk. Everything God is speaking we can hear. Because they were so surprised.
Then the pastor.
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
Hey, both of us are
trouver. They didn't recognize themselves.
But as a
they started questioning themselves. They were so surprised. When did they
land?
How it happened in our city? They forget that God, that Jesus, had promised about the Holy Spirit. Because He told them, I'm going
to
go. But I'm going to send you the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is going to teach you multiple things. More than the way I teach you. They forget. And you today, you forget. And then you just say, maybe, I was speaking my
language.
You forget that Jesus said, I'm going to send you Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. So when they started laughing on God, by saying they are drunk, but Peter was there.
He
stood up. And then he started showing them. What he started telling them.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Peter
said,
telling them by saying, these people you are seeing, they are not drunk the way you think about it. Because it's still just, it's 9
a.m.
Who can be drunk at 9? The thought you are having is not the same. It's not the same. Still 9 o'clock.
I didn't finish a day.
When is the time? Jambo hili, ni lile alilosema nabii Yoeli.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
Ema unataka mkusikie sasa.
The things you just hear.
Mwe mnawaza sema nalewa
pana. And you think they are drunk.
Mkumbuka mambo mprofeti Yoeli alisema.
Remember about the prophet Joel. Remember about the words Prophet
Joel.
Because it's the same when Peter was laughing. So Peter reminded them to remember about Prophet Joel.
I say my name, Pastor.
Na wakili
Amen, amen, amen.
And then he said that at the last days, even my servant, men and women are poor the Holy Spirit. So they'll start prophesying. They'll start prophesying. Why? Because of the Holy Spirit that God has sent to them. So it's going to give them power to do the things.
Amen.
We have to believe in, and we have to believe we have the same Holy Spirit today. The things you are speaking in front of people, you have to understand you have Holy Spirit. If you don't have Holy Spirit, you will see this place is very hard for you. You will arrive here, and then you can be speechless. Yourself, if you confess it, you prepare yourself. Maybe you can prepare yourself, but you, when you arrive here, and the fire is going to be upon you. The reason why God says,
at that time
I hold my spirit upon my servant,
he's
going to start leading them. We have to search our God. We have to look for Holy Spirit. We can have all happiness in our life.
Amen, amen.
Amen. This is a God who is speaking. I will do wonders. I will do miracle in the world. And people will be questioning how these things happen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
What is it?
Do you hear what God says
here?
The sun will be dark. It's
going
to be red. Before those things happen.
Amen, amen.
Amen. We have to fear when we are walking. We have to be together with God. Because when you buy your gold chain, and then when you put it in your hand, you will keep it seriously. Because you know you spend a lot of money on that chain. So I want to destroy it. The same way our God is more than God. When you keep him, he's going to keep him in
your hand.
The reason why he said when those things happen, I'm
going
to perform a lot of miracles. And those people who are without God, those people that are ignoring my name, they went through fire. Because he said the sun is going
to
be dark. And the sun is going to be like a black. It's going
to
be dark. There won't be anywhere to run. So if you abandon God, you will miss nowhere to run.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Everything
who is going to call the name of Jesus at that time is going to be saved.
It's
going to be saved. Even if you went through an accident, you came out alive. Even the suffering in your house,
you won't touch it.
Because you have Jesus.
Because
you walk with Jesus.
You
keep Jesus. And then he's keeping you safe. That's why he says, at that time, everyone who's going to call upon my name, he's
going
to be saved.